Good candidates for the calcium score are people who don't have any symptoms but are worried about whether or not they have underlying coronary disease. A typical age range might be between people who are about 40 to 70 to 75 years old, with potentially a little bit on either side of that. Patients especially who have high blood pressure, family history of heart disease, high cholesterol, who are worried if they have any evidence of buildup of plaque in the arteries.
Your head will go on the pillow. And your feet will be hanging off the edge down there.
We will bring you into the CT room. We lay you on the table, laying on your back, and we put actually four leads on you, kind of like having an EKG. We put two up near the clavicle and two down by the lower portions of the rib. The gating will actually get picked up on the machine that you're attached to, and it syncs with your heartbeat. So when we do the scan, it eliminates the motion of the heart. We'll push you in, we line you into the machine. I like to call it a donut. So you can see be out towards your feet, and you can see above your head or on the sides. So it's very opened. The machine will tell you when to hold your breath and when to breathe. And then we step out, we take some quick pictures. The test takes like less than 3 minutes. When you're doing a cardiac scoring, it's actually picking up the heart plaque or calcium in the coronary arteries. And then once we're done, we come back in, we take the leads off of you, and then that is it.
So the radiologists look at the scan for any calcium deposition in the heart arteries, which can be evidence of blockage in that area. If there's a high calcium score, then usually the next step is to see a cardiologist, determine what the next step after that is, which could be stress testing, could be angiography to look at the heart arteries. If there's no noticeable calcium, usually that's just a very reassuring result. The patient and their primary doctor often can just continue working on things like blood pressure, cholesterol, like they normally would. If there's kind of a mild to moderate amount of calcium, that's also where sometimes a heart doctor can help them decide what might be good options to be more aggressive to prevent any further accumulation of disease. We do rarely find patients that, even though they're having no symptoms, do have severe buildup of calcium or very high calcium scores. And in those patients, oftentimes we can make a diagnosis, offer them treatment, get them treated such that we can hopefully prevent what could be a life-threatening complication in the future. The major risk we think about when you look at calcium buildup in the heart arteries is that of heart attack. But because the same disease that affects the heart arteries affects arteries of the neck, like the carotid arteries, you can also impact people's risk for stroke and other vascular problems. This is absolutely a measure of prevention for cardiac disease. I think as heart doctors, we'd really like to see these patients in the office before they have a heart attack rather than in the emergency room after they've had a heart attack.